For this week's video, I am back out in the mountains of the Isle of Man. When I say mountains, technically the Isle of Man only has one mountain, so it's mountains slash hills of the Isle of Man. It's a cold, sort of dreary November day, and my goal today is to shoot some nice images of some Manx Tholtan ruins that are sprinkled in this area. So I'm currently in Tholtywill Glen, which is one of the main sort of valleys that leads up into the mountains slash hills of the Isle of Man. And behind me, back there, about a mile away, is the furthest of the ruins that I'm trying to get to. So there's three sort of ruin sites that I'm interested. They're all situated relatively close together. So I'm going to go for the most difficult one first and then work my way back. Now, all three of these locations I've never taken pictures of before. So I'm really quite excited about what today has in store. For long-time viewers of my channel, you may have noticed something. The awful fingerless gloves are back, and that can only mean one thing. It's winter time. I'd actually forgotten just how beautiful this bit of forest is in this first part of the walk. It's absolutely glorious. It must have been about 10 years since I've been down here. It's a really lovely spot. Already I've been distracted by some possible compositions, but I'm gonna plow on because I really need to get to this furthest Tholtan, and it's still quite far away. The hat is off and my hair looks awful, and the terrain is starting to get pretty difficult. The path has all but disappeared, so from here on in, it's Google Maps all the way. I think it's going to be quite difficult to get to this ruin based on this terrain. There's a lot of dense vegetation, a lot of gullies, streams. Yeah, it's going to be a challenge. The first ruins of the day. I finally got here after one hell of a trek. That mile walk felt like a 10 mile walk because I kept on going off in the wrong direction through thick woodland, and I had to turn back on myself. It was really, really difficult to get here, but well worth it. This is Ballaskella, and it's a location I've never visited before, and first impressions are that it looks absolutely magnificent. What a location here up in the hills of the island. The light is a little bit lousy today. It's not quite as it was forecast. I'm kind of hoping that might transform a bit over the next hour or so, but I'm gonna have a little wander around here and see if I can find any compositions. What a location this is though, and I love how connected it is to other vlogs I've done. So just across the valley there in that deep plantation, I did a vlog there where I visited Craig Moore Tholtan, and you can find that link to the top now. And just a few weeks ago, sort of back there, probably about 2 miles or so, is the one where I went to the Croit. And that was another beautiful spot, and you can find that link to the top now. And in the next few weeks, I intend to shoot a vlog over there because there's another beautiful ruin that side called Killabrega, and it's a location I know very well, and I really, really want to show it with you. So fingers crossed, I'll get a vlog there very soon. But enough of that, let's get stuck in right here. Nothing's ever straightforward, is it? Literally, after just filming that nice little piece there, I climbed over this barbed wire fence here, and as I was climbing over, this post kind of gave way, and I felt myself falling back, and I've literally ripped my jeans and ripped a chunk out my leg. I'm in absolute agony, and I fell back and I landed on my camera gear that was on my back. Thankfully, it's just down here. I've had a little look through and everything looks to be okay. A little bit shaken, but I don't think it's enough to stop me today, but it might slow me down a little bit. But it just goes to show you've got to be very careful when you come out on these kind of vlog trips into these remote locations, because that could have been a hell of a lot worse. Thank you. I've had a good look around the ruins and they're absolutely spectacular. To think that someone actually lived in this location is really hard to fathom. It's absolutely beautiful. But my light is just lousy today. It's making everything feel flat and lifeless. And it's a real, real shame because I think there's an awful lot of compositions to be had at this location. The weather forecast seems to suggest that this cloud cover is going to break up a little bit in the next hour. So I'm going to wait around and see if they're actually true to their word, because I have picked out a few compositions already, but I just need a little bit more to lift them to another level. This is really disappointing. The light continues to be so flat, and this is really not what was forecast, so I'm a little bit disheartened at the moment, but I'm going to stick with it and hope that things turn around. I've got my first composition set up here, ready, just in case I get the right light I need. So let me explain exactly what I'm doing with this composition. I'll just walk you down here. So you can see just behind me here, I've got this beautiful old wheel here that's part of I think it's a mill unit that must have been housed in this building, and that is the main foreground interest in my shot. There's actually a second sort of cog that's kind of in against the wall there, and I've also got that within the composition. So both of these cogs lying in the grass here with this old wall are really what this shot is all about. And then if I walk you back up this way, back to where my camera is. Okay, so obviously my camera is just set up here very, very precariously on the wall. I'm a little bit nervous of it, to be honest, but I'm staying close to it in case I need to do some sort of Superman dive to try and capture it. But yeah, just above the wall, you can see there's an area of sort of golden kind of dead bracken that kind of sits above that. And then you've got a really nice view up that valley with nice layers of mountains, kind of sprinkling of woodland. But what's just not working at the moment is the light isn't playing ball. The sun is kind of over here somewhere at the moment, and I just need a little bit more to work with in the sky. It's just flat and uninteresting. I don't care if the light doesn't come and illuminate the foreground so much. That would be nice, but it's not essential. What I just need is a little bit more texture in that sky, something a little bit more to lift the image. I think the weatherman was talking utter. It does not look like that sky is going to clear anytime soon. Although, having said that, it does look like we're getting a little bit more texture and definition in there. So I think there's probably actually enough to work with now to try and take the image, which is good. In terms of settings for this shot, I am going to pop on my circular polariser just to add a little bit more punch and saturation to the colours. I've also stuck on a two-stop soft edge ND grad to try and add a bit more drama into that sky. And settings wise, I'm shooting at half a second, f11, ISO 64, and I'm focusing in for the cog in the foreground. And I think that should deliver quite a nice image. I believe it's kind of the kind of shot that I probably want to come back and get another time, because I think with just the right conditions, it could be absolutely incredible. But I think it's testament to the fact that it's a strong composition that it still works in flat light like this. I'm going to focus stack this image as well, because when you're looking at that cog is actually quite close to the camera, so I don't think I'm going to get the depth of field I need if I focus in on that cog. So if I take a two image focus stack, one image focused down for the cog, another down on the background there, and then compile them in post-processing, I think that's going to give me better sharpness throughout the image. I'm about ready to leave now and head back to the other Tholtans that I mentioned earlier. I've only got about 2.5 hours left of daylight, and yeah, my leg is really, really sore, so it's going to take me quite a bit of time to actually get back to the beginning of my journey. So I don't think it's sensible to hang around here any longer. Hobbled my way back to the second Tholtan, and this one, I believe, is called Faulty Will. and it's a location I've never visited before, and I have to say it's got an awful lot of potential. This building just behind me here is really, really pretty. I'm just sitting sort of back from it, and there's a great view out over the valley with that, but also from the other side it looks quite nice as well. So I think there's an awful lot of potential in this location. Just not today. The light is just rubbish. It is really, really rubbish, and I don't think it's going to change anytime soon. So today has very much turned into a bit of a scouting trip, which I'm a bit disappointed by, but at the same time I'm not. It's a good opportunity to come out to locations I've never visited before, kind of get a feel for the locations, and then hopefully in future when I get a bit more luck with the weather, I can come back and do them some real justice. Back to where it all began. That was a really, really tough return journey. It was so, so long with this injury. It was tough, tough going. The third set of ruins are just down there, a couple of hundred meters away. But to be brutally honest, I'm not gonna go there now. I'm just not. I'm gonna save it to a future vlog. The light is rubbish now. My motivation and energy is zapped, and frankly, it feels like I've been shot in the leg. So I don't think I'm in the right condition to go down there. I'll be back to this location in future to shoot there and to return to those other ruins that I showed you, because I think there's a lot more potential there just with the right conditions. The conditions weren't really very kind to me today, to be honest. So I didn't get as much photography in as I would have liked, but it's just one of those things. I had a really enjoyable day nonetheless. So that's it for today. I'd be really interested to hear your thoughts on the one image I did get and the locations that I visited during this trip. Also, if you've encountered any incidents where you've injured yourself or had sort of near misses when you've been out vlogging, I'd be really interested to hear your stories as well, because it's gave me something to seriously think about. As always, any likes, comments or subscribes off the back of this video are very much appreciated, and I'll see you all soon for more landscape photography. Goodbye.